Hey everyone, this is Tim from Your Six Studios. Today in this video, we're going to be doing a review for the AG9 Plus headset for the PlayStation 4 console. Now you can also get this on Xbox. And the PS4 and Xbox versions do work on the PC. Now, this does come with an $80 price point on Amazon currently right now. And when you open up the box, you're gonna go ahead and receive the headset, the microphone, the manual, the USB charging cable, and the USB dongle that will transmit sound wirelessly to your headset from your PlayStation 4 or Xbox. Now, the build quality of the headset, I think overall, is pretty good. I've had other headsets in the past where the headband right here will actually snap. Now, these don't rotate at all, but they do move it in and out just slightly. And the microphone, as you can see, is in a fixed position, so it will not rotate up and down or collapse in. But you can detach the microphone by grabbing it and taking it out. And any point in time you want to place the microphone back in, you can easily go ahead and just reinsert it. And the headband right here, I said on other headsets, it tends to break. Well, this one is actually pretty sturdy, and it feels like it won't be breaking on you anytime soon. And if there's a point of failure on the headset, I don't think this will be it. Now, the headset does have a weighted feeling to it, and it is a little bit larger headset. The speakers on here are 50 millimeters. However, being a larger headset, when I put it on my head, it still feels comfortable. And I've worn these headsets for 12 plus gaming sessions, and I haven't had a problem. Now, it is primarily comprised of plastic, and it also has a mesh inner lining. And the headband right here is comfortable. It has a padding to it on the top, and it has a breathable mesh in here also. And I can go ahead and press on the padding right here, and it actually feels really good. The headband is actually wide enough if you want to go ahead and wear a hat on it. It will actually collapse around your hat if you're wearing one and go ahead and fit snugly on your ears. Now, speaking of the earmuffs on the headset, if you do have a little bit larger ears, these are large earmuffs. Yeah, and they do provide you a good amount of depth to them. These go in quite a bit of ways, and I haven't had any problems with my ears rubbing up against the speakers. If you are somebody who does wear glasses, which I occasionally do from time to time, when you put your glasses on, there is a tightness feeling where the earmuffs are actually pressing on the back of your glasses, and that can be uncomfortable over time. However, this leads me to have to push up the end of my glasses up and over the earmuffs, otherwise that will start hurting after a couple hours of gaming. But pushing it up and over the earmuffs, it seems like it's fine. Now, the microphone, this is an improvement over the previous models, which I have sitting right here. If you can see the PDP Sound of Justice and the PDP Crawls, it's far more flexible. And since this is a fixed microphone positioning, having a flexible microphone is actually really helpful. Otherwise, I would be stuck having it just in one place like I did on the other models. It's nowhere near as good as your Blue Yeti. However, my friends have stated it sounds crystal clear in the PS4 party chat. And I've noticed it can be a little bit slightly more quiet, but one of the big things about the microphone is the sound canceling technology that's built in. Now, I can be sitting here and typing on my keyboard, and this microphone won't be picking it up if it's adjusted accordingly on the PlayStation 4 settings or the Xbox settings. And this does have active mic monitoring, meaning when you're speaking in your headset, it will actually pick up your voice and it will play it back in your speakers. Now, I've noticed it's not quite as loud as other headsets. Like, I have a Turtle Beach headset and it seems like that one's quite loud. Well, this one, I can barely tell what's going on, actually. I have to press the microphone very close to my mouth to actually start hearing myself in the speakers. If you're wishing to adjust your mic monitoring, there's no additional settings to adjust that. Now, all the buttons are located on the left earmuff. You will have a volume control button right here, which obviously controls the volume up and down. You will have a USB charging port located right here. And here is a bass boost mode, which when you press it will increase the low end sounds and make them easier to hear. And this actually works quite well. I've noticed there is some distortion to the bass sound whenever I use it. However, when I'm using it in Call of Duty, I like to have it on when I'm playing Blackout. Makes it a lot easier to hear any kind of engine revving sounds, any kind of footsteps that are off in the distance. Now, I noticed, sadly, there is no 3.5 millimeter auxiliary input on this headset, and I'm not sure why PDP didn't put this in there. On my other models, the Crawls, the Sound of Justice, both of those headsets have that ability. And this is a bad thing if you have a capture card and you want to capture your PS4 gameplay and add your microphone or have the audio come into your headset. You won't be able to connect your headset to your capture card at all. And many people want to get into streaming with a professional level capture card. You're not going to be able to do it with this headset. So that leaves me to have to use my previous models whenever I stream. Now, the sound in the headset is actually really good. It has two 50 millimeter high definition speakers in it. This is not surround sound. There's only two speakers, but this doesn't really affect my ability to determine if there's someone behind me when I'm playing Blackout or Fortnite. I can hear the footstep, the sounds, and I can react and accurately determine where they are. Not having surround sound really isn't a negative at this point with this headset. All the audio is very clear, it's loud. And this is a wireless headset. It comes with a USB dongle, and there's approximately 40 feet of range, which is great if you're going to be running to the kitchen or to the bathroom in between games. You can still talk to your friends and get the party chat you want. And the battery life of this headset is approximately 15 to 16 hours, which is going to be plenty for the average consumer for a couple days. And I think in terms of the wireless headsets under $100, the battery life is top notch. It's really good. It's comparable to most Turtle Beach headsets. Now, the lights on the headsets, it's not just for show. They actually mean something. When the headset is trying to connect, it will flash green. When the headset actually connects to your PlayStation 4 or PC, it will turn solid blue. When the headset is charging, it will blink blue. And when it finishes charging, it will turn solid blue. Now, I did want to talk about the reliability of this headset and PDP in general. As you can see, I have three different PDP headsets. I have bought four of them throughout my lifetime so far, and all these are purchased within 3 years. And the unit I'm currently holding is a replacement unit. I was sent two replacement units by PDP. Out of the four headsets I bought, two of them had microphone issues, and one had an issue with the charging port on the headset itself where the unit didn't charge. And only one headset was outside of the 2-year range for the limited warranty. So the reliability of this product for me is questionable because I've had issues with 3 out of 4 headsets I've had. And I've come to realize the customer service for PDP is quite excellent. They'll most likely send you a replacement unit that is comparable to the unit that you had prior. So this does make up for some of the faults in terms of the reliability, because I was sent a new headset and I'm actually really happy with it. So just a heads up, if you are having problems with your headset, it has a 2-year warranty. Contact PDP customer service. Do not send your headset back to wherever you bought it from. Contact PDP and they'll take care of you. And from the beginning of contacting them to when I actually had my headset in my hand and unboxing it, it took about a month. Now, I love how comfortable PDP products are when I place them on my head. They feel great and I can wear them for hours. And the sound of the headset is really good. With the AT9 Plus, the microphone is much improved. Not having a 3.5 millimeter auxiliary line in kind of sucks, because I love to stream from my PlayStation 4 with my capture card and I use OBS a lot and I can't capture that sound. And the reliability of the headset is quite questionable with a lot of my headsets breaking, but the customer service is really, really good and they'll most likely send you a new headset. I still recommend this product because how comfortable it is and the length of the battery life is about 15 to 16 hours. And the price point of $80 for a wireless headset. And if you get this headset on sale, I got my PDP Sound of Justice for $40. Watch out for really good deals. And this headset can be an absolute bargain. And I wear this for 3 or 4 hours plus a day. and I really enjoy it. And I think this is one of the best wireless headsets for under $100. So check out the AG9 Plus from PDP. If this video helped you out on determining if you're gonna buy this or not, make sure to leave it a like and subscribe to my channel down below, and check out some of the other videos coming up next on Your Six Studios.